their program, Aviation Horizons. The goal is to lead teens toward a lifelong interest in piloting and away from entering the world of drugs and alcohol. And that's what we're looking at in our cover story tonight. Mary Ellen Burns joins us with more. Mary Ellen?
Karen, that's right. In our cover story tonight, we'll look at an innovative program started right here in the Granite State. Aviation Horizons in Nashua will be graduating its first squadron of pilots this summer. And what makes this program unique is that the pilots are high school students. The point of the program is to motivate and challenge young adults who otherwise might be tempted by alcohol and drugs. That's all coming up in our cover story tonight. Karen, other negative influences around them. So they decided not to send off a check to an organization, but to form one of their own, one where alcohol and drugs aren't welcome, and the students must stay in school. Combine that with a love for aviation, and that's how this program got started.
I'm bringing these kids forward and see if we can't get them into something which would challenge them and make a better opportunity for them than they might otherwise have. A lot of them would not have an opportunity to even fly, other than perhaps a commercial airplane ride.
We haven't required that they be youngsters who are doing real well in school, and they're not necessarily top students. In fact, one of our aims is to take students who might not be doing well, and through motivating them, get them to redirect their attention to do well. So it was a little harder than we thought.
And after a year of planning, Aviation Horizons started out in November with 12 students. But committing to be in a classroom every Saturday morning from 8 till noon weeded out 5 students. But the remaining 7 are committed to become licensed pilots.
I'm now looking towards aviation as a career, but it's something I always wanted to do, and I'm glad that I finally get the opportunity to do it. It's something that I don't think I would have ever done if I wasn't given the chance.
I remember the first night when we had our books, I was looking through it and I didn't understand a word. But then the next Saturday when I went back and they were explaining it to us, it was really easy to catch on to.
See, Brian, you know why it's not 6,000?
Classroom space is donated to the program by Daniel Webster College, one of the top-rated aviation schools in the nation. 3 Daniel Webster graduates and 1 senior are the flight instructors for the program. Since November, each of them has donated about 500 hours.
I wish I had that opportunity when I was starting out. And it just really sounded like something that was really worthwhile. And the end results would definitely be positive. And I like flying.
I think the biggest change I've seen is in the attitude of the students. When they first came in, I think they were really shy about what they knew. And these kids weren't real school kids, you know. They were more the type that didn't do well in class and didn't do well on tests. But I can see a difference teaching the class now, since we've started, that they're enjoying learning this information. And I think it's really helping them study, and I hope it's kind of bleeding over into school and helping them in school too.
And once they get into the planes, I'm sure a lot of what they learn on the ground, they're gonna have to apply it in a plane, so we're gonna have to go back to the beginning and tell them, you know, how it happens.
The students at Aviation Horizon should be taking the written portion of their recreational pilot's license test sometime next month, possibly putting them in the cockpit of one of these planes as a fully licensed pilot by the end of the summer.
You picture yourself in the airplane. It's like you're flying a plane, taking off. It's pretty exciting.
I want to be an aviation mechanic from here and just fly planes for pleasure.
But in order to get all of these students up and flying, Aviation Horizons is in need of a $15,000 budget. So far, they only have 20%, but they're keeping their fingers crossed that some potential sponsors will come through with financial support.
It's something I've always been interested in, I guess I just didn't ever think it could happen. And then with the help of Channing and some of the other flight instructors, I've been able to reach a goal that I never thought I would.
It gets you more motivated at school, you know, to help you out with your study skills.
Karen, they're hoping to expand Aviation Horizons to a second squadron in the Worcester, Massachusetts area next fall, in addition to the squadron in Nashua.
Very innovative program, and we'll be interested to see how the students do on their tests. Thanks, Mary Ellen.